Hello, baseball fans. You're watching On Deck with Tyler Redmond.
Darryl, you've been on top of the world in baseball, and to go from that to what you're doing now, I mean, what's the difference? Do you get the same rush from it? Now, tell me about just what you're doing now and how you got here.
Well, I'm in ministry now, you know, so I'm an evangelist and I travel, you know, close to 250, 60 times a year, encouraging people through, you know, the gospel. The rush I get in this is far greater than I got when I played baseball. You know, baseball was a thrill. It was just a game, sport. You play it and you play it at the highest level and you try to achieve great things. And I was able to do that. But at the end of the day, what does it all mean after it's all said and done? You know, it'll be with you for your history and everything, of course. But, you know, this life and being in ministry, serving the Lord and winning souls is far greater than anything that a man could ever think about. I think I've been able to see two sides of life. Maybe see the first side of being, you know, this baseball player and having adversities and going through trials and tribulations. Then I come over on this side, and now I find complete freedom. You know, I get to live in wholeness, happiness, and peace. You know, it's not about money, it's not about fame, it's not about success. It's about the joy, you know, that one can wake up and know that you're in purpose. And you're doing things to help others. I think that's more important. Like I said, playing baseball is not going to really help others. It's going to make people happy for the moment in time. But I think on this side, this is the eternal gift, you know, that I get to receive from God and be able to go back and really empower somebody's life.
And I want to talk about what you're doing today. Of course, you're here in Columbus to benefit the Carpenter's Ranch. And, you know, you're seeing young kids, you know, that are going through some of those same trials and tribulations of today's world. You know, what does it mean to you to be able to give back to them?
Well, it breaks your heart, you know, that you see so many young people are hurting. And we live in a society that's very broken, that's very dysfunctional. And our young people don't believe that it's something there for them to achieve in this life. And of course, you know, the ranch here, you know, they do a phenomenal job of bringing the kids back to life. I always call it a rescue, redeem, and restore. And then you have a program that you can go through and you could be educated that your life could be different. I mean, the education is the most important part of the young person's life. And if we don't educate them that they can achieve no matter what, you have to believe to be able to achieve. And that's the most important thing that we have to encourage our young people, because young people come from really hard situations these days. You know, I came from a hard situation myself, so I know that firsthand. And you just hope that they can get out of the darkness and get into the light. That's the most important thing. I think having programs like this and what they do at the ranch and different places to make a difference in these young people's lives.
If you could give me just a little bit of your testimony that you're going to be sharing today with these kids.
Well, I always share my experience, strength, and hope, you know, more than anything. I mean, everybody has a testimony. Testimony is you don't get a testimony until you pass the test. You know, and I think I've passed the test over many years ago to be able to have a testimony to show people that, you know, where you come from is not the end. You know, where I came from, like I said, from the top and to the bottom of being successful and having the trials and tribulations and not giving up, endure, keeping the faith. And you know, I was thinking it was through other people, you know, through the prayers of my mother. It was through my wife leading me back into the church. It's people there that try to guide people along the line when you're going the wrong way. It's just a matter of, do you listen? And that's what happens to most people. They don't listen. You know, I finally got to the place of listening, and the results have turned into me being an evangelist, preaching the gospel, and traveling the country to make a difference in other people's lives. So, you know, those are the kind of things I like sharing.
Well, let me say I really appreciate all the work you do for young folks and for folks all across this country. I want to talk about baseball just for a minute. You break in 1983, and 3 years later, your team, the Mets, is winning the World Series. You know, what kind of rush is that? What kind of joyful moment is that?
It's a good question, you know. Because I was 24 when we won the series. And so you always think that's going to happen again. And it's just a short window of time. you know, when you play baseball and get to experience things like that. And that was a great experience to be able to win at such an early age. And I thought, wow, this is going to happen again. It didn't happen again until later years in my career. But at that time, when I was 24, that was probably the biggest thrill that I could ever receive, is playing in the series and winning. Because you grew up as a kid, and I think that the most important thing, you look at baseball when you're playing, you watch Major League Baseball, and you don't see the game. You see team that wins, and you see the team that lose. You know, the team that loses is the one that's where the player in tears. You don't want to be on that end. And, you know, I never been on that end, the losing end of it, but I saw those moments, and I just wanted to experience the team that was having the great success during those times. So I was very fortunate to be able to have that in 86 and then later in my career. So it was a thrill, you know, to be able to do it and actually do it at home too. You know, it was an even bigger thrill.
You mentioned great success. Not only did you guys win the World Series, you came back to win the World Series. Game 6, Bill Buckner misses the ball behind the bag. Mookie Wilson is safe. Ray Knight comes around third and scores to advance to Game 7. You know, what kind of thrill is that? I mean, you guys not only tied the series, but go on to win it, I mean, in comeback fashion.
Well, that was a great thrill. You know, everybody wants to blame Billy Buckner for the play, but Billy Buckner was a heck of a player, and he didn't get the credit that he deserved. And you think about that Game 6, it came down to a play, but it came down to other pitchers couldn't get anybody out either, so the game was never over. Until it's over, until the last out was recorded, you know, so it didn't happen. So we ended up being in a situation where we would win Game 6. But then they realized we came back Game 7, we were down 2 in that game. We had to come back in that game. So we came back in Game 7 to be able to finish it off. But it was a great year that year with that team, 86, because we were never out of the game. We felt like we were always come back and win a ball game. And we did it so many times in that regular season. We did it in the playoffs against the Astros. And now we get to do it against Boston, and we go on to win the championship.
A great postseason environment. Another, you know, great postseason environment, I would say, is what's going on in baseball right now. The World Baseball Classic. Of course, the finals are tonight between Team USA and Team Japan. Have you watched any of it? Have you been a fan of the World Baseball Classic at all?
I have not. Have not seen any of it. You know, I saw some of the clips of it, you know, from guys getting hurt. You know, and I think back, you know, Diaz getting hurt from the bats, and that's a big loss, you know. And that's a risk you take. You know, you play in, you know, WBC. It's a chance, you know, it's early in the year, early in the spring, and guys can get hurt. But at the same time, the excitement for the fans, you know, for each country that is playing for the country. So it's a lot, you know. It's I heard some guys saying it was bigger than the World Series. Yeah. No, it's not. Nothing's greater than that, you know, because when you went on this stage, it's forever. You know, I don't know about the WBC. I had never had a chance to play in it, but it looks exciting. It's real exciting to see what is taking place. And, you know, I guess the United States is in it, you know. They got a chance. They go on against Japan, so it should be exciting.
It'll be an exciting game. And I want to talk about this upcoming season. Opening day is, I think, 9 days away. It's not far. There's a lot of changes in the game. You were a great player. How well would your batting average have improved if you didn't have to hit against the shift?
Oh, well, I don't think all that stuff is part of baseball. I think all the changes that they've made are more like little league than, you know, professional sports. I think you should keep the game the same way it's always been. I mean, it's been there for many years. I know a lot of older players like myself that have played, you know, we think we were too thrilled about seeing the shift. We wasn't too thrilled about, you can't break up a double play, you can't find a catcher over. That's baseball. Can't take that away. Now they have this clock, time clock that they own. I don't understand it, but, you know, I guess they understand it and they have to live with it. Adjustments are part of what they have to do every year, it seems like, in Major League Baseball. They have to be able to adjust to different things. And I think this year I was down spring training with the Mets, and I saw that, you know, pitch clock, you know, saying you got to try to shorten the game. Just let the game be the game. It's always been. If it's 3.5 hours, it's 3.5 hours.
Well, Darryl, I really appreciate you being here. I really appreciate all the work you do for folks again all across this country. And thank you for letting me interview you.
Thanks for having me. Appreciate it.
Baseball fans, make sure you like and share this video and subscribe to this channel. As always, thank you for your support.